Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Taqabbal Allahu siyamakum wa qiyamakum. And inshallah, all of us will be those who are exposed to Allah's mercy and forgiveness. Dear brothers and sisters, our topic today is what defines nobility? Is it a royal blood or a blue blood? Is it wealth? Is it the color of the skin? Is it your profession? Is it your income? For the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is none of the above. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came up with a new definition for nobility. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born on 12 Rabi' al-Awwal of the year 53 before Hijrah. Corresponds with the 22nd of April of the year 571 of the Common Era. And with his birth, a new dawn had arrived over humanity. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the son of Abdullah, the son of Abdul Muttalib, the son of Hashim, the son of Abdi Manaf, the son of Qusay, the son of Kilab, the son of Murrah, all the way the son of Adnan, who was a contemporary of the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, the son of Ismail, alayhi salam, 2,000 years before then, and the son of Ibrahim, alayhi salam. He's the best of the best. You don't find any pedigree or any ancestry tree look like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have many ahadith which tells us that. But the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he mentioned facts like this, he always says, wala fakhr. It is not for a show off or a pride. This position in Quraysh and in Arabia is very important because it tells the people himself, without doing anything, he's destined to be the leader of Quraysh, the leader of Arabia. He would fill the shoes of his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. He would be one of those oligarchy who are running the show in Mecca. And most likely he will be the king of Arabia because of his caliber. That's without doing anything, based on this ancestry only. And on the other hand, this answer for those who think Islam is a revolution of the poor against the rich and so on, of all of these, what we see of projections of philosophers and so on. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not an adventurer. He was not nobody. He is very well known. He's in the midst of Quraysh. Everyone knows him. Everyone knows his family and so on. But with this in mind, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not willing to take advantage of his ancestry. And from day number one, he told his family, O Quraysh, work. I cannot help you in front of God. Ya Bani Abdi Manaf, i'malu la ughni ankum min Allah shay'a. Ya Bani Abdul Muttalib, i'malu la ughni ankum min Allah shay'a. Ya Safiya, عمّة رسول الله اعملي لا أغني عنك من الله شيئا يا فاطمة بنت محمد اعملي لا أغني عنك من الله شيئا. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم is redefining what is the best and what is the noble. And he warned all his followers and especially his family, don't come in the day of judgment with your pedigree, with your family tree, to show it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so you would be saved. Nothing will save you but your action and deeds, to live the noble life, to be morals. And he told us, man batta or man abta bihi amaluh, lam yusri' bihi nasabuh. A few good deeds and actions are short, your pedigree will not make it up. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam redefined nobility and made it available to everyone. It is the character, it's the morals, it is not the birth or any of those social things. And it is accessible to everyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this very clear in the ayah, Ya ayyuhal nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila li ta'arafu, inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. The best among you, who is the best in the sight of God. It's not your gender. It is not your nationality. It's not your race. It's not the color of your skin. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in his last sermon on the mount, had told us, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, inna rabbakum wahid, your Lord is one. Wa inna abakum wahid, your father is one. لا فضل لعربي على عجمي ولا لعجمي على عربي. No advantage for an Arab over non-Arabs or non-Arabs over an Arab. ولا أحمر على أسود ولا أسود على أحمر. And no advantage of a white over a black or a black over a white. إلا بالتقوى. But by righteousness and good deed. And the Muslims had applied this. And we see in the day of Fatih Mecca, after the Kaaba was cleansed of the idols, swept away and thrown in the garbage, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered Bilal, the black man from Ethiopia, who was tortured, and he earned his position to be the master among the Muslims. Umar ibn al-Khattab, he would say, this is Sayyiduna, this is our master. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered Bilal to climb over the Kaaba and make adhan. This slave who was tortured, who was he and his mother Hamama, were subjected by Umayyah ibn Khalaf to all kind of humiliation and physical abuse. Now he is standing on the top of the holiest of the holy to make adhan. And the message is very clear to everyone that any human being is far more holy than the holiest of the holy. To destroy a soul of this kind is in the sight of God worse than destroying the Kaaba and worse than destroying the whole universe. Where are we from the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And we see people are killed right and left without knowing why they are killed. Bombs exploding, terror everywhere, and so on. Where are they from the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And three people who just became Muslim, because the day of one day before then, it was when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave amnesty to everyone. اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء. Three of them were sitting whispering. Abu Sufyan and Attab ibn Asid and Al-Harith ibn Hisham. And they were full of still arrogance of Jahiliyyah. And they whispered, don't you see that black man on the top of the Kaaba? The second one, he said, my father is very lucky being dead and he has not seen this. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came from far and told them, I have heard what you have said. Abu Sufyan did not make any comment because he told them, I swear to God that the garvel beneath my feet will tell the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam if I open my mouth. So the message we have today, to be noble, live a noble life. Live a moral life. Do good deed. Be beneficial to your family, to your society, to your community. This is the only criteria in the day of judgment will work, and nothing else will work. May Allah bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.